smell everything. You want to taste.
Thank you. One class.
You need a 101 class.
Sometimes like this.
Necesitamos parques caninos.
Necesitamos parques caninos.
Donde los perritos puedan jugar libremente.
Donde los perritos puedan jugar libremente.
Wir brauchen Räume.
Wir brauchen Räume.
Wo man zusammen sein kann.
Wo man zusammen sein kann.
Die keine Konsumansprüche haben.
Die keine Konsumansprüche haben.
Man sollte Glückshormon ins Trinkwasser mischen. Business und Stadtverwaltung.
Und alle sollen viel weniger produzieren.
Damit sie mehr Zeit füreinander haben.
Damit sie mehr Zeit füreinander
haben. In times like this.
In times like this.
We repeat what they say.
We repeat what they say.
To amplify each other's voices.
No matter what it is.
So we can hear one another. Many thanks.
Many thanks.
Danke vielmals.
Danke vielmals.
Gracias.
Everybody is gone. Thank you. Sprache ist und ich kann schon ein bisschen vorgraben. So I will also say it in English, in addition. I will dig a hole and I will first tell you a bit where the hole is and why, and I already also tried different places here. The thing will also be broadcasted, so I think they only hear me, so don't worry. Feel free to check. But we don't walk far, so the ground is very soft, and you can also see a bit like the companies around here. You see the playground. You also see a bit the houses. They continue, so it's very nice. But then I thought it's in a way it's too far, so I will show you the next place that I mean, it's also just you know, this ground is kind of. It's also said here on the info panel. Also, es gibt hier auch so ein Infoplakat. Da wird es auch gesagt. Also es gibt auch so recht viele Altlasten hier auf diesem Boden und so. Also einfach so als Info. Deshalb ist auch der Boden.
Thank you.
Kann man nicht runterfallen. Der Turm kann ja.
Okay, I don't have aqua viva, but I have something alive here. This is the kefir. And kefir actually is like a culture, and those cultures they are also called Japan crystal because they look like crystals. But if you can touch them and you can eat them as well, bacillus and yeast cultures. And normally yeast cultures and lactobacillus, they're everywhere. They're free floating. We have bacteria on our body. We have it between our tooth. We have it in the gut, in the vagina. It's like everywhere. And also everywhere in the embryomen, you know. We look out here and we have an overview of Neu-Oerlikon. And we kind of see far, I see Paperberg, maybe because of the weather, not as far. We see this world, but it's just a tiny, tiny little part of a much bigger world. And not only geographically, in a sense of macro, but also as well in a sense of micro. So going all into the level of molecules and eukaryotes and prokaryotes. Prokaryotes are like one-cell living beings. The point is that those living beings, they lived 500 million years longer than before human mankind started to exist. Mm-hmm. And inside of ourselves, compared to that one being that we are. And also, if you stretch out the whole DNA of all those bacteria, they are 50 times longer than all the DNA we carry as humans. And if you start 50 times longer than all the DNA we carry as humans. And if you start to think about this, we also start to realize that we are not this one being that we fall. We are made of many. We are made of trillions, actually.
They are
responsible for our digestion as well. Food is the only way how we, not only food, breathing as well, but how we get in contact with our physical world, the material world inside, like here outside, flowers, food, everything. And because, for example, when you touch something, actually you never touch it, like the electrons, they push each other away, so we actually never touch something at all. But our food chain as well. Humans fermented food since the beginning of civilization. It actually was the reason why we civilized ourselves. I mean, it was the booze, that's why we stayed and we harvest our corn and stuff. And this fermentation we produced for 10,000 of years. And since 50 years, since we started to have super chain, like supermarkets and also refrigeration, we had to stop fermented in that way that we have to standardize our food. That means those products which are fermented that you buy in the supermarkets are pasteurized food. So they kill the living bacteria inside our food. And there's actually much more food fermented that we think of. There's beer, wine, all the cheese, yogurt, there's Worcester sauce, mustard, ketchup. All the goodies, all the things which are
the processed thing, which are good, those are actually originally fermented foods. And many people, also in connection with pharma industry or so, each time we eat antibiotica, we are killing as well the bacteria inside our body and our guts. Not all of them, of course, but they found out that, for example, autism or Parkinson, before you can diagnose this disease, people complain about digestion problems as well. Its original name is also Tibicus. It existed here since long. There were waves where it was more popular than before. So now there we are in a wave, it's more popular. And last time it was in the 80s, and back before it was 68. And that before it was pre the First World War. Because if you start cultivating your kefir, it's like a pet you grow at a certain amount to still enjoy it. It gets just more sour. But in one moment, it's not as tasty anymore. Because then else, you realize that fermentation is the same like decay as well. There's this tipping point theory. Once you hit the point, then it starts to make a chain reaction. So everything is ambivalent. In one way it creates the life, but in the other one as well, it's also decay. I'm sorry, I wanted to cook for you and make the taste everything, like the weather is.
Yes.
Thanks, Maya.
Thanks a lot.
And thanks, everyone.